Hey guys, it's Work Rivers and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Chrome on my list. Me 1 and 2. Which is against Watford and Manchester City. In which. I won't spoil what happened. Just go back and watch. And be ready to be amazed by some of FIFA history, personal FIFA history.
The FA Cup don't really need to say much more than that, Alan.
No, you don't. The papers have been full of
those. You did see the last week, so I will know really what game happened. So please no spoilers. So you go back and watch the film, so because it's very good episode. So there's more and work to happen.
Pretty robust start to the game. It's certainly a foul, but the referee's kept his cards in his pocket. May. Here's a chance to move forward from midfield.
You have to be committed to watch my videos, to be honest. I don't know if I'll have done it already by the time I record it. Actually, I don't know for a fact that.
Hutchinson.
Yeah. Nice return pass. I said that wrong. I meant to say, I don't know if I have recorded by the time I've uploaded this. If you guys, for those of you who are probably wondering, where's the review yesterday of yesterday's MLP episode? I could not find a English version of the episode that hadn't been taken off of YouTube, or a Daily Motion is a big bag of shit. My apologies if you like this, but the fact that the video, anything you try to watch on there, it's just slow as hell. It's constantly freezing, have to pause so it can, catch up and get ahead in terms of the timeline. It's just a mess. So I better watch it on YouTube. Trying to track down a full version, hopefully. By the time I've probably gonna post this first, though. I might do the review afterwards, because I do have to watch the episode. I've only seen bits of it so far. Although, the bits I have seen, I can say without doubt that I am disappointed.
He steps up for the free kick. And the goalkeeper
Ooh.
To make the save. Coming up now.
Keeper at him. Take a very important save there. Yeah. As I was saying, from the clips I've seen, I'm disappointed because I really don't want to talk about it because a lot of you probably don't watch the show. Probably for the same reason I didn't for the longest time, but if you are interested, I would implore to at least give it a chance, because you never know. Because I didn't think I'd like it. I was asked to just give it a chance. I said, you know what, I will. I might as well, because you're not going to stop for our running. He talked to the person who convinced me to give it a watch. And I'm glad they did, because it actually really surprised me. And, you know,
it's very good positional.
I would say start from the beginning. Start from the beginning. Because otherwise you'd be completely lost if you started like.
And he's reached it well.
Anywhere after the very first episode. And, you never know, you might find yourself easily hooked. Because, as I said, I'll watch one episode. Then, before I knew it, I had watched all of season one, half of season two. I was like, hang on a second, I'm still watching it. It was just so easy to get lost in them. In the ship itself.
Well, in this FA Cup tie, the second half starts now.
Yeah, well, the first half didn't disappoint. Hopefully the second will be no different.
Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession.
Very, I'm actually glad I did, because, well, the episodes I've seen so far, or this season, have been hit and miss. As it is, 50-50 in this season so far. They're probably not the best. Yeah.
They've gone up to take the throw, well up the field, keep the pressure on.
So, that's my recommendation for the day, ladies and gentlemen. Check it. Oh. You know, if friendship is magic, because, you know, you never know. You never know. You never know until you know. You know? Yes. Makes perfect sense.
Here's an update for you on a potential target for the Spanish club Valencia.
Quite a bit of money, about £60 million we hear, but you can understand why they would want to invest that amount.
Oh yeah, that happened in the last episode. I got a really big offer for to the Mets, but I told, I think it was Villarreal? No wait, it was Valencia. Yeah, my Spanish team's mixed up here. Her Wells is new. But yeah, I told him to go to hell, because there's no way I'm selling to the Mets. So that is why that popped up. He did not ask to leave, he's not going anywhere. I disallowed future offers as well, so I think. Or was that for somebody else? Well, if we come out of this match and there's an offer there for him, then I know, then we'll know. But there shouldn't be, I think I just. I know I disallowed the offers for someone. I'm hoping it was Dylan Mendes.
It's
been a few days since I played this. Still waiting for the FIFA 17 demo to drop. It's not fucking dropping. They're being stingy with that fucking demo. I don't know what the fuck is the problem. I mean, the demo. A lot of people use the demo to gauge whether they're actually going to buy the game or not.
Be influenced so often by substitutes, the home team.
I know my friend always asks to play the demo of a game before he's, if there is one available, before he decides where he's gonna buy it or not. Because he says it helps him gauge whether he's gonna enjoy the game or not. And I think that's actually a very good idea. Yeah. I recently played a demo of a game that I've decided I'm going to have to get because it was amazing. I had heard good things about the game, but, you know, I decided, you know what? Rather than, you know, jump balls deep straight into the game, and commit myself to buying it and getting it and stuff like that. I mean, that's what it's all about, because I saw there was a demo of it.
On the edge of our seats here.
Bit, huh?
It's that close.
the PlayStation Network, they were like, you know what, freaking go for it. And I am super excited too.
Really a very thoughtful one.
I'll probably be more super glad when I actually get the game.
Working hard in that respect, but
that's a penalty, thank you very much.
And at this time in the match too. The penalty, I think it was clear cut, and the fact that the
Mills on his
is that a bit lenient?
Maybe, but
return back from loan.
The penalty, I feel, is
when's the penalty? Galanti, who's got a very good record, continues that very good record. Seriously, 21 million. Why? Why did Chelsea sell him to me? Hey, with all the goals he has got, he's gonna.
Restarting.
If it was any other player in front of him, he might already be in the starting lineup, but unfortunately he has Ronaldo and Neymar in front of him in that in particular their line. But if it were, I'd say almost any other player, he'd be that. If I had Messi and one open slot, Ancelotti would fucking get it. I just wish he was like a real player who could like sign up. I mean, I could create him, but when FIFA 17 comes up, but that would be like not in. I'd love to, I know he's Italian, so he's obviously someone's region. The question is, whose region is he? I think he's Totti's, but I can't be sure for. Or that I'm wrong. Because I probably am. Of course I am. Actually, let's just assume for argument's sake that I am. This is our future offers. Dude, one freaking game! Seriously, where is the option to talk to your players? Tell them they're not being tossed to wayside, but they keep pissing me off. I might just. Calm down. Calm down. Yo, everyone is getting offers. How's he getting offers? What's here? Oh no, I gave him my reject disallow future offers. Shut up! Here by any chance. No. There we go. There he is. Oh, alright. Huh? Oh wait, I just, that's why I was, I guess that was disallowed because I did just disallow the switch offers. No way, I did. I was gonna say, did I change the team? Yes I did. Yes, I did. Yeah, that's okay. Does that match go up again? Pretty sure it just went up to an A7. He is killing it. If only this wasn't the last season before FIFA 17. If only. Unfortunately, it is. Fortunately, we're only in January, so
good. To express themselves, and it's reflected.
And I completely forgot to see Chelsea were playing at the same time as me.
Nine wins in nine home games. No complaints from the fans here.
Well, I guess I can look at halftime.
Aymeric Laporte as the centre-backs. Gareth Bale starts with Marco Reus in the wide positions. Cristiano Ronaldo plays up front with Neymar. Aston Villa make three changes today. John Flanagan starts with Leandro Bacuna in the full-back positions. Patrice Gay plays with Jordan Henderson in midfield. We'll
see how the strikers work with just one up front. Nathaniel Klein. Tenements.
Villa have possession again. Elm. Jordan Henderson. That's a good challenge between the two of them there.
Yeah, good defending on there. Straight away. Yeah. Oh, that's it.
Oh, penalty. No question. The decision is made by the referee. It is a penalty. And the card is yellow.
Just wondered about the colour there.
And scored!
Damn it! Of course! Skip this bullshit.
He knew exactly what he wanted to do. You could see that. And gave the keeper no chance with that one.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. Defenders worried now about Cristiano Ronaldo. Slip past his man now. And no scraps for the attackers to feed off from the goalkeeper that time.
Go, Neymar, go. They made a mistake. Now punish them for it. Nathaniel Klein. Brain is, of course, offside. Because, of course, he's offside. Fuck you.
Gay. Jordan Henderson. Free kick given.
Oh my gosh. Go on, take it quickly.
Neymar. Brilliant technique in the tackle.
Oh my god, I can't get in. The offense in. My players seemingly can't make a goddamn pass or go fucking anywhere or without losing the ball.
First touch was poor.
Oh, great. Yeah, goodbye, America.
Been booked, that would have been a yellow card.
Wait, I don't think it sent him off. Oh. Guess he got away with a warning. Thank goodness.
They are the league leaders, Alan.
No, I shouldn't be playing my temper for dictate how I'm playing the game, but this game is really thoroughly getting on my nerves. Thank you, Vrain.
Well, he's hit it hard and he's hit it first time.
I can't believe in my goddamn center. Her back. I got to come from the fence to get me. Now that bind. Well, wasn't really a bind, but.
Corona.
This game is screwing with me. Yeah, I don't like it. Yeah, actually, let me pick the right player again. Stop. Bitch. Go, Neymar. Go. Go.
Potential in this move. Royce! He's kept it out. Shot off!
Yes! 2-1 Philip Coutinho. Oh. Oh. Doubles the leads. Royce's shot was probably going in anyway.
A top class, really, here.
Well, talk about luck. The keeper makes a good save, but straight into the path of the attacker.
Another angle on it here.
Can't really tell.
What I can tell is that was Coutinho's 15th goal, whether the ball from Neymar was going in or not. Doesn't really matter. It wouldn't matter if it was a defender, although if a defender had kicked it in by mistake, it would have gone down as an own goal.
Ricardo Rodriguez. That's going to run on through to the goalkeeper. Well, that is half time, and we've reached it at 2-1. Half time here, and it's looking.
Half time, 2-1. Crap, I skipped past it. I saw them, though, so Chelsea are playing. I think they were winning. Coutinho, in off the post. Beautiful assist by Neymar. That's the second Coutinho goal, and the second Neymar assist.
What a strike that was. It's just
yeah, Brazilian boys are really linking up.
Here is another angle on that goal.
Beautifully. Right between the defender and Ronaldo.
We restart the game. Ricardo Rodriguez.
Coutinho.
Referee's given a corner.
Yeah, him for some reason wanted me to kick it out of play. What the fuck? I press his X to tell him to pass it into the Coutinho for no reason turns to fucking kick it out play randomly. Luckily the defender was where he was or it would have been a goal kick and I would have been super pressed. I don't know how I can get any more angry than I am at the moment, but, you know, we'll see. We'll see how things go.
Aston Villa might have a problem. It's a corner.
Mikel Richards prevents Coutinho getting a header on it.
Tries to punch it away.
It's put Bale back on corners. Why did it do that? Clever bit of defending there by, I think that was actually Jordan Henderson.
Leandro Bacuna.
Yeah, it was too. The header back to the keeper. Oh, but he's made a
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Be a negative to that positive by giving the ball away. Oh. Nathaniel Klein is open.
EA Sports continues its coverage.
Oh, good. Spurs again. Because I didn't just play them recently. Yes, I did. Twice.
Get excited about it, and I am as well.
I might have to. Actually, I am gonna bring America off for fear that I might accidentally do something I shouldn't do. Shut the bitch down. And I'll bring Aquilante on for Coutinho. That's as Coutinho would probably want his
Barclays Premier League. Can't really see too much between the sides. I think it'll be close. Elm, Jordan Henderson, and it's now with Liverpool. Coutinho.
Hat trick, unless he can get it before the substitution happens. He isn't gonna get it.
But not high enough. Royce!
Good save. Bale was canals. That's probably gonna be it. Challenger, right?
And the goalkeeper
with a textbook save. Oh, my keeper and defender were going to make a huge mistake there, but they didn't.
Coutinho
might get one more shot. The player's been waiting for ages over there. Oh, just wise. A mark. Oh, frick. Captain's armor, man. Gone.
Here's a chance to move forward from midfield after that interception. And that's dealt with the problem. From him. Aston Villa readying a substitute here. 84 minutes gone, 6 minutes to go. Back to him again. An opening for Aston Villa. This might be it.
No. Oh, yes, good block, Rodriguez. Yo, the counter attack. Aquilanti? Surely not. He's all home with the keeper. Is he going to bury it? Oh, the keeper with a fantastic save. With his face.
Gay. Idrissa Gana Gay.
Good challenge by Nicholas. Oh. Oh, and there's the full time whistle. Thank goodness that's over. Chelsea did win. Is it too much to ask that they drop more points so I can build a even bigger lead than 21 points? I mean, 21 points is, well, a freaking massive lead, but come on, Chelsea. Oh, wow. Nicholas was gonna transfer offer. Nope. Public contract offer accepted. He took his time on it. Accepting that, didn't he? Oh, looks like Laporte is suspended. You know what? Nicholas can take his spot for that game. Why not? I think he did very well in the dying moments of that game against Villa. Another defense, absolutely fucking not. One, they're apparently rival, and two, they're assholes, so they can double fuck off, if that seems possible. Or are they really? Yeah, it does a lot. Yeah, I would love to see if, like, there's a message that pops up. Sorry, you cannot approach this player. The team and coach have disallowed offers. Or some shit like that. That would be weird. It would be cool, but it would be weird. Oh. Anyway, that will be the end of this episode. Thanks for watching. Hope and enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.